Good morning, everybody. Today we will study the factorization of polynomials. Factorization already we studied what is a polynomial and degree of a polynomial. Next we will study factorization of polynomials. This year we want to study only the factor theorem and factorization of polynomials based on only factor theorem. Okay, the remaining portions are excluded from our syllabus in this year. Okay, so factorization of polynomials. Factorization of polynomials. We have to study the factor theorem. Factor theorem. P of x is a polynomial of degree n greater than or equal to 1. And if a is any real number, P of x is a polynomial of degree n greater than or equal to 1. And if a is any real number, then x minus a is a factor of p of x, then p of a is divisible. X minus a is a factor of the polynomial p of x, then p of a is equal to 0. Or if p of a is equal to 0, then x minus a is a factor of that polynomial p of x. In our textbook, the factor theorem is there, page number 40, factor theorem. If p of x is a polynomial of degree n greater than or equal to 1 and a is any real number, then x minus a is a factor of p of x, then p of a is equal to 0. Or if p of a is equal to 0, then we can say that x minus a is a factor of p of x. That is called a factor theorem. Based on this factor theorem, we have to study the problems on exercise 2, 4. Only 4 problems are there. Remaining problems are deducted from our syllabus this year. Okay. So, we want to study the factor theorem. And based on factor theorem, we have to study the problems. Exercise 2, 4. Only the first problem. Okay. Here given, determine exercise 2, 4.
Exercise 2, 4.
First question, determine which of the following polynomials has x plus 1 a factor.
Determine which of the following
polynomials has
x plus 1 is a factor.
Check whether which of the following polynomials has x plus 1 is a factor. You know factor theorem. If p of x is a polynomial of degree n greater than or equal to 1, then x minus a is a factor of p of x, then we know p of a is equal to 0. Here p of x is given. First question, p of x is equal to x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. We want to check whether x plus 1 is a factor of this polynomial p of x. Check whether x plus 1 is a factor of the polynomial p of x. By factor theorem we know that. We want to find out p of x. First we are going to 0 of this x plus 1. That is 0 of x plus 1 we know. 0 of a linear polynomial we already studied. X plus 1 equal to 0. 0 of
0, that is x is equal to minus 1. So here we have to find out the p of minus 1. That is equal to 0. P of the value p of minus 1 equal to 0. Then we have to say that x plus 1 is a factor of this given polynomial p of x. This way we can use in factor theorem, check whether the given polynomial is a factor of the given polynomial p of x. Okay, that is minus 1 the whole cube plus minus 1 the whole square plus minus 1 plus 1. Minus 1 the whole cube, negative number raised to power is a whole number, we get to the negative sign. So minus 1 the whole cube, we get a minus 1. Negative number raised to power is an even number, we get a positive number. Minus 1 the whole square, we get a 1. Plus minus 1 plus 1. Minus 1 plus 1, 0. Plus minus 1 plus 1, 0. We get a 0. That is, P of minus 1 equal to 0. So we can say that x plus 1 is a factor of the given polynomial. P of x is equal to s cube plus s square plus x plus 1. This way, using factor theorem, we have to check x plus 1 is a factor of the given polynomial. That's the first question we already saw. So, using factor theorem, we have to check whether x plus 1 is a factor of the given polynomial. P of x is equal to s cube plus x square plus x plus 1. First, we have to find out the 0 of x plus 1. We know how we can find out the 0 of a linear polynomial, equating that polynomial equal to 0. That is x plus 1 equal to 0, we get x is equal to minus 1. So we can find out the p of minus 1. Also we know that x plus 1 is a factor of p of x, then we know p of minus 1 equal to 0. Here we get p of minus 1 equal to 0, so we can say that x plus 1 is a factor of a given polynomial p of x. Okay, then here 4 problems are there based on this. That is, this exercise 2, 4. Two more problems are there, 3 more problems are there. Second one you will do it as homework. Then third one. Third question. P of x is equal to x raised to 4 plus 3x cube plus 3x square plus x plus 1. Check whether or determine whether x plus 1 is a factor of p of x. First we have to find out 0 of x plus 1. That is, equating x plus 1 is equal to 0, we get the x is equal to minus 1. So we have to find out the p of minus 1. Minus 1 raised to 4 plus 3 into minus 1 the whole square plus 3 into minus 1. Sorry, x raised to 4 plus 3x cube. There also cube. 3 into minus 1 the whole square plus minus 1 plus 1. Okay, 3x cube 1. Okay, one more time I will check it. Question number 3. It's x raised to 4 plus 3x cube plus 3x square plus, yes, x plus 1. Then minus 1 raised to 4. This power is an even number, so it will become plus 1. Plus minus 1 the whole raised to 3. Negative number raised to power, odd number, it will become negative 1 into 3 minus 3. Plus minus 1 the whole square, 1 into 3, 3. Plus minus 1 plus. Here we get a minus 3 plus 3, 0, 1 plus minus 1. 1. That is not equal to 0.
Therefore, we can say that x plus 1 is not a factor of given polynomial p of x is equal to x raised to 4 plus 3x cube plus 3x square plus x plus 1. This way we can check whether the given polynomial is a factor of the polynomial p of x. Okay, then one more question is there, that is the fourth question.
1 root 2 is there, so
and what would this problem also?
Fourth question, p of x is equal to s cube minus s square minus
minus 2 plus root 2 into x.
S
plus 2.
Check whether x plus 1 is a factor of the given polynomial p of x is equal to x cube minus s square minus 2 plus root 2 into x plus root 2. Check whether x plus 1. So first we have to find out that 0 of x plus 1. So equating x plus 1 equal to 0, which implies x is equal to minus 1. So we have to find out the p of minus 1. That is minus 1 the whole cube minus minus 1 the whole square minus 2 plus root 2 into minus 1 plus root 2. Okay, minus 1 the whole cube. Entry number raised to power is an odd number, it will become minus 1. Here minus 1 the whole square plus 1. Here only 1 minus is here, so minus 1. Here 1 empty side is in the outside and here outside 1 bracket is here. So first we have to change. Multiply minus 1 into these two numbers. Okay, that is minus 1 into 2, minus 2. Minus 1 into 2, minus root 2, plus 2. Then, minus 1, minus 1, change the minus into minus 2, plus 2. Minus into minus, plus root 2, plus minus 1, plus minus 1, we take it, minus 2, plus 2, plus root 2, plus root 2, 2 into 2. So we get a 2 root 2, which is not equal to 0. Therefore, x plus 1 is not a factor of the given polynomial. P of x is equal to x cube minus x square minus 2 plus root 2 into x plus root 2. So we can say that this x plus 1 is not a factor of the given polynomial. Substitution, find the 0 of x plus 1, we get a minus 1, p of minus 1, minus 1 the whole cube minus 1, minus 1 the whole square plus 1, and here sign is minus, here minus of minus 2, sorry, minus of 2 plus root 2 into minus 1, x is minus 1 plus 1. And here I am changing the bracket. Multiplied by this minus 1. This minus is an amount right here. Minus 1. Here minus 1 we get it. Here minus 1 the whole square plus 1. Minus 1. Minus 0. Minus into 2. Minus 2. Minus into root 2. Minus root 2. Plus 2. Then change this bracket. Minus 1. Minus 1. Minus into minus. Plus 2. Minus into minus. Plus root 2. Plus root 2. Minus 1 plus minus 1, minus 2 plus 2. 0 plus 2 root 2, we get 2. That is not equal to 0. Therefore, x plus 1 is not a factor of the given polynomial.
Okay. Let us say 2, 3 is deducted from our syllabus this year. And 2, 4 only this problem we want to check. Next, we have to study the algebraic identities and based on the problems. In your textbook, 8 identities are there. But this year, we want to study only 7 identities and 8 identities also vectors from our question. Okay? So, algebraic identities. Previous class. Okay. Then first identity.
X plus y the whole square. You know, y plus b the whole square. You already studied. Here we have to write x and y. Then you know, x square plus 2xy plus y square. And second identity. X minus y the whole square. You know what is a minus b the whole square. Same identity. X square minus 2xy plus y square. Then third identity, you know, a square minus b square. Here only a square minus y square. That's equal to a plus b x plus y into x minus y. Then also fourth identity, that is x plus a into x plus b. That you already studied previous class, I think in the 8th class. That is equal to a square plus a plus b into x plus ab. X plus a into x plus b is equal to a square plus a plus b into x plus ab. These are the four ideas I think you already studied. Remaining three more ideas we will study this. That is x plus y the whole square, that is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. Second identity, x minus y the whole square is equal to x square minus 2xy plus y square. Then third identity, a square minus y square. That is a square minus b square also. A plus b into a minus b. Right here, x plus y into x minus y. Here x plus a into x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a. These are the four identities. Then three more identities are you have to study this year. That is fifth identity. X plus y plus z the whole square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2x. This is the fifth identity. X plus y plus z the whole square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2xz. Then the sixth identity is that you already studied. That is x plus y the whole cube. That is x cube plus 3x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube. Or this we can pronounce, that is x cube plus y cube plus. These two terms we are taking common factor 3xy into 3xy into x plus y. These are the two identities I think you already studied in the 8th class. S plus y the whole cube is equal to s cube plus 3. First time in the square, x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube. You can rewrite it this way. S cube plus y cube, no, second time. Y cube plus these two can common factor 3xy into x plus y. Okay. Then next seventh identity. Seventh one. X minus y the whole cube. That is s cube minus x square y plus 3x y square minus y cube. S cube minus 3x square y plus 3x y square minus y cube. Here, one term is negative, that is 3x square y. Square y term minus 7, minus 3x. Examiner, you didn't make a mistake. Here 3x square y is minus 10, 3x y square is plus 10. Here also we can take a common factor and write here, that is x cube minus y cube minus 3xy into minus 3xy into x minus x cube minus y cube minus 3xy into x minus y. Oh, these are the seven identities. One more time I explain. X plus y the whole square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. X minus y the whole square is equal to x square minus 2xy plus y square. Next one, x square minus y square is equal to x plus y into x minus y. Fourth one, x plus a into x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a b. This is the fifth identity. X plus y plus z the whole square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy, 2 into x into y, plus 2yz, 2 into y into z, plus 2xz. Then, these two identities, x plus y the whole cube and s minus y the whole cube, already studied, a minus b the whole cube and a plus b the whole cube. That is, x cube plus 3x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube. Here, s cube minus 3x square y plus 3xy square minus. Okay, next, eighth one identity say that it is deducted from our syllabus. Here. So, next we have to study the next exercise, exercise 2-5, that we will study the next class. Then all of you find out all the 7 identities, write and study. Okay, thank you.